Today I have called you for the simple reason that you are going to embark on your SIP journey from tomorrow or couple of days from now. So I want to let you know something I know about SIP. Internship program for MBA PGDM students. Internship program. An internship is a period of work experience offered by an organization for a limited period of time. A SIP includes the plan, the resources, and processes to bring an intern that can contribute to the organization's goals, accomplish predetermined tasks, and receive experience, supervision, and expertise for their time and energy. Benefits for employees. Don't think that you are going to be benefited. You are going to be benefited at the same time. You are going to give an opportunity to the employer or the organization owner or the giant stock company where you are working. It also will be benefited, provided you do something which I am going to explain later on. It is not one-way traffic, please. It is two-way traffic. Build capacity and bench strength. Sometimes employees are fired. Maybe those who are on bench may not get the opportunity like you get the opportunity like pre-placement offer if you are doing better. Those employees who are already on the rolls may not be up to the mark as compared to you. Access to new expertise, trends, and educated talent. Please don't underestimate yourself. You are an educated talent for the organization to bank upon. Opportunity to evaluate and screen students for full-time positions. It is a free thing, please. It's gratis for the organization, which gives an opportunity for you to intern there. Consistency of interns each semester. Every time, for example, you are going to be a brand ambassador of DHRUVA, and if you do a better job, probably they will compare with other institutions and also your own institution. For example, your juniors will be offered better positions in internship. If you behave well, that will set a trend for the organization to go for DHRUVA again and again and again. Fresh ideas and energy. That is important. If you do internship religiously, your ideas, after all, everybody has an idea, and the idea whose time has come is more powerful than a bomb. Benefits for student interns. Job and workplace experience. Job, a real-time experience. Embellishes resume. Please understand, once you do internship and you are conversant with what you did, verbatim, that can be posted on your resume, a CV, or by a data. And that will add to your profile. Internship credits and MBA and PGDM program. There are, I think it is 4-credit program at DHRUVA as a full-time subject, a full-credit subject. Financial incentives. There are paid internships also. I have at least 3-4 HR internships ready. Those who are interested, they can go for paid interns. Not necessarily paid intern is important, but there are many times internships are given on payment. And Prakash was telling me the other day, there is an internship program where 25,000 rupees per month is offered. There is not news to me. It happens. Build a network, get exposure to industry, society. It's a networking thing, please. You can get buddies, friends, and you can enlarge your network, and you can know the practicing managers, the industry, the customers, the clients, and the society at large. Potential for increased starting salary. Please understand that not only you will get pre-placement offer, if you do well, not only the salary that is given for a first-timer or kind of first-time job holder, you may be considered for better pay. Like it is happening in Carvey. All the B schools in the city are given not more than 2.5, except DHRUVA. They are paid 3 and 3.5 as a starting salary in Carvey. The reason is simple. Yashwant did a wonderful job there. And Sadab knows, I know, He has done an online project at the behest of Carvey. And faster ramp up with first time full job. It is important, please. You get to acquaint. First time jobber is like a girl going to Sasural, or a boy going to a Sasural. I don't want to undermine my girl children here. It is going to a different place. So once you are acclimatized to this new environment, it becomes easy, smooth sail over to the new organization wherever you are going to be employed. Process recommended. Establish SIP goals and objectives. Very important, please. A goal or objective cannot be too many, please. I prefer only one objective, one liner. Better set goals which are accomplishable, verifiable, reasonably good. Don't try to go to climb Everest. Think of smaller hillocks. And once you set the goal or objective, you try to accomplish it to the fullest extent. Don't do a half-hearted job. Please understand that. Once you set a goal or objective, it should be accomplishable, verifiable. Please understand that. If at all there is some other goal which is addendum to the original goal, you can have tertiary goals as subsidiary goals, but the main goal should be only one. Do literature survey. I'll come to that literature survey a bit later. Complete orientation on and off. Visit organization before you start. Incognito, you go there as nobody. Go there and just observe situation and see what is happening. Decide discrete projects intern can do additionally. Not only the project that is given by your faculty guide in consultation with the functional guide in the organization, you can do some tertiary projects too. Discreetly, you can think about it. You can really impress upon your guide and the environment there and the management there, and you can do some more projects. Have a faculty mentor and functional guide. We do it here. The faculty guide is as important as functional guide and vice versa. Get performance reviews, feedback by both the guides on daily basis, please. You must maintain, if not journal, but a diary too. You must maintain, please. This is a must. This is not happening. Please, those who do religiously, write a diary, not even journal, please. Every day, at least 5 to 6 days a week, depending upon the company's policy. Every day there must be a journal. It must be transcribed to your functional guide as well as faculty guide through mail or on phone. Make organizational buddies friends. Make friends. Wonderful place to make friends, I say, of different cultures, different religions, different regions. Please don't underestimate your position there, your program there, your stay there. Perform as per the instruction of both the guides. If you do more than what is required, that is discrete projects with the permission of the functional guide or the management where you are working. But as far as SIP is concerned, be confined to the objective and at the behest of your guide, functional guide as well as faculty guide. Literature survey, as I promised that I am going to speak on literature survey a bit later, that is this. Very important, sir. For any research, you have got to do literature survey. Whatever the topic you have chosen, go to Google and press it. There will be umpteen number of surveys or research being undertaken all over the globe. Don't reinvent the wheel. What is happening along with you? See what is being done elsewhere, wherever in the world, and try to compare what is being ordained on you by your both the guides, and compare. It is happening elsewhere already. You are not the unique person in the world. Thus, research may be undertaken, or already papers are published, already articles are published in the books, monographs, unpublished literature. All those things you must see, please. The literature review is a written overview of major writings and other sources on a selected topic. Sources covered in the review may include scholarly journal articles, books, government reports, websites, etc. The literature review provides a description, summary and evaluation of each source. It is usually presented as a distinct section of a SIP or dissertation. Literature review is very important. You can do right after this session. Nowadays it is very easy, please. In our days, when I did my PhD in 1977 up to 85. 8 years I struggled. My literature review consisted of 5,000 pages. I went to many organizations in the country, including Delhi, including American Library, including many, many IIMs. I could not find the literature as much as I wanted. Nowadays, it is on fingertips, please. You can do wonders. Just type the topic and you will get umpteen number of sources and you can have fund of information. And based on that, your research can be focused upon. Going weird way or dilutory way, you can focus on the objective of the topic. Because somebody else has already done it. The approach he has taken, the verdict he has passed on, the epilogue he has written. Epilogue, I am coming to epilogue, please. Epilogue is very important. Whatever the project he has done, it is not end all, be all. Maybe something which is missing. In your own opinion, had you had more time, you would have done better than what is being done. You can always project it and epilogue. This is the way it can be further researched upon this topic. That is called epilogue. The opposite of prologue, please. That is not a must. But those who are really keen researchers, they can always add to the research as a final section of the SIP report as epilogue. Record individual reviews on a template with Harvard-style bibliography. Take cut A4 into 8 pieces. A4 into 8 pieces. Write down the topic or the article, the book, the author, and the source of publication. All those things you can write. That is to be done in a Harvard style, please. We are following as a uniform standard procedure. DHRUVA follows Harvard style. Nothing great about Harvard style. Some standard practice we are practicing. That is simple. That is author, Hazer and Render. You got operations management. I have taken the same subject. Published in 2008. As far as a particular topic, particular article, particular subject, particular authors are concerned, there may be a number of publications, please. Which publication we are referring to, that should be important. For example, Philip Kotler, I am told that he will not repeat the messages or the script he has written before. There are 18 volumes, 18 reprints, 18 kind of editions of Philip Kotler. So unless you write the year, nobody can have a clue. Literature review, as far as bibliography is concerned, it is like your address. Address should have the name, house number, street number, and the village or the borough, whatever it is, and ultimately the city and the pin code and the country. Same way, the literature survey will help you or the onlooker or the examiner to look for the source. And nowadays it is easy for the examiner, for the third party to verify whether it is plagiarized or original. Nobody is original, sir. As you know, I am a very famous copyist. But I always give credit to the source. I take sources. I really cull down from the sources. I know. But I definitely give kind of credit to the source. As long as you are giving credit to the source in the form of bibliography, you are safe. Otherwise, you will be caught, please. All my faculty colleagues will not take kindly to plagiarism. If you copy and don't give credit, is called copying. Plagiarism is the worst disease. I don't recommend anything. If anybody is caught copying something, you are gone. Success factors. Eliminate just an internship. Chalta pirta aana, jana, nai jana, gappe marna, gazip mangari. Just an intern. Kya dekh raha hai, kon hai, Pratap Reddy aa rahe hai, Sadhav aa rahe hai, kon aa rahe hai. Faculty guide ko kuch to bhi likhenge, manayenge unko. No, please. You are a brand ambassador of DHRUVA, sir. What is, after all, brand? The logo, the name, the pattern in which you behave, the summum of your individual personality as culled out from DHRUVA with 1 year experience is your brand. You your 4Ds, your USP, your tagline, everything will be manifested in your stay in the organization. And they should know, oh, here is a DHRUVA guy. That's how brands are built. Time management. Pakka time pe aa rahe hain bhai. Are bhai, ye DHRUVA ka hai bhai. Are overtime kar raha bhai. Ye DHRUVA ka hai bhai. He is presentable always, I say. Well dressed, well kept hair, well polished shoes. Ye DHRUVA ka hai bhai. He is never gossip mongering. He is always work. He is busy working. He is busy contemplating. Busy discussing the issues with his peers and the functional guide. Everything is manifest, and which is nothing but brand. DHRUVA brand is paramount, please. You're all brand ambassadors, please, not just our faculty. All of you, each one of you is a brand ambassador of DHRUVA. Make a name for DHRUVA and earn credits for yourself, not just credits and marks in the memorandum. Make your stay in the organization credit worthy, rememberable, memorable. Please understand that. Become welcome to the organization. People should feel, are bhai, ye bhai, ye bachcha nahi aaya. Are, oh, he is on leave today. Your absence should be felt. Then only you are an entity. Your absence must be felt. Are, this boy who is so hardworking, so diligent, he is not available today. Oh, what happened? Yes, he has applied for leave. Nothing wrong. All 3 months you are not working. But be known, whether you are present or not. If you are present, you are bubbly, you are ebullient, you are dynamic, you are effervescent. Everything is known to everybody. DHRUVA, DHRUVA, DHRUVA. Perform roles, responsibilities, goals and tasks assigned to you by your faculty guide and functional guide. Be committed and seek management support. Get insight how internship relates to business goals. Very important. Your objective may be really one sentence, but how it is juxtaposed to the organizational goals. Organization is a big machine and you are a simple, small, temporary cog. Whatever little contribution you are making, it is for the benefit of the organization. In the end, please understand, it must merge with organizational goal. Get insight how internship relates to business goals. Find the proper leads and support. Proper leads, known, unknown, subtle or manifest. Schedule time for transition and documentation. Must schedule time. Don't waste your time after coming, going home. Be done with it. 8 hours, 9 hours you are working there. Be done with the project. Don't carry the work home. You enjoy. After all, your age is for enjoyment. Nothing wrong in that. As you are working here 9 to 5, same thing there. Of course, once in a while your guide has to remain extra hours. Fine. But as far as girls are concerned, be careful. Don't go beyond the scheduled time. Unless it is known to your faculty guide and your parents. Maybe we don't know. Somebody may be hoodwinking you. Must be very careful. You must be guarded against that. Girls, especially, I am telling you. Maintain journal, presentation, wrap up, everything. Everything should be systematically done. Staying connected after the internship. Don't burn the ship after you cross the river. Please don't do that. Continue the connection. Make it effervescent. That's how you build up your circle, please. I was an introvert. My circle is very, very limited, sir. That's how I really, when I look back at my life, no good. You must be bubbly, I say. You must be friendly. Your friendship should be large. Your friend circle, the radius must be very large enough. After all, vasudhaiva kutumbakam. You are the citizen of the world. That is the philosophy of DHRUVA too. Make friends as many as you could and continue the friendship for a positive connotation. Onboard checklist. Be welcome to all employees. All employees, sir, including the chowkidar, not Modi, please. discuss start and end dates with the both guides. Define work hour and on-site expectations. Practice dress code and day one directions. There will be tahzeeb of the organization too, like we have DHRUVA tahzeeb. Follow organization tahzeeb there, not DHRUVA tahzeeb, please. Collect supervisor information and buddy information, our colleagues, our peers who are working along with you or in different organizations, where you, different departments. Please make a note in a subtle fashion. And don't ask the name, please wait, let me write down your name. Not like that. You're all intelligent and ekasantagrahis. You can remember the names and you can write down. After you get acquainted, you can ask for the phone numbers, mail ID, etc. Collect list of co-projects, owners, contacts. There may be projects simultaneously being undertaken by the company on its own or some other friends from different B schools. Maybe some projects are similar to you. You can cooperate, coordinate and co-opete. Please understand that. There is nothing wrong. Don't be selfish there. I kuch nahi jata. No. Help others, take the help. Enlist intern supplies resources. Once you go into the organization, you know what are the supplies available. Don't hesitate. Verbatim follow orientation outline and more. Day one or first week probably you will be orientation. You will have orientation. Induction program like it is done in DHRUVA, July 15 to August 15. Verbatim note down. You must follow the orientation regulations. Verbatim. No deviation from that. Whether it be tahzeeb, whether it be rules and regulations, written, unwritten. Please understand that. Who are the owners? How old it is? What is the philosophy? What is the culture? Why Infosys is so famous? Please understand that. The cultural ethos are very important. View bigger picture. Do not just be done with the projectization. No. Go beyond. Have a big picture. After all, you are going to be a CEO one day. No less than that, please. Don't underestimate, you will end up with only vice president. No. Have a big picture. Earn regular training and development. Meet guides regularly for feedback and check status. Whether you are on schedule or behind or ahead, depend upon that, you have to expedite certain things. For example, what we do in operations management. Our order is given, we have to supply March ending. And it takes about 3 months. At the fag end of December, are we able to supply those merchandise March 31st? If you are not able to do it, you do work, do overwork, overtime work, extra time. Or if you are on schedule, go as usual. Don't be lazy. Request for an exit interview. Hello. Exit interview is important, please. You must have an exit interview with the company guide and the related to the company guide who are subsidiary, who are supportive guides there. Not just one guide. Depending on, for example, you are doing on finance. Maybe your functional guide is marketing. Definitely you have to make use of the service of his compatriots in the organization from across the departments. So, have an exit interview. Identify improvements to your internship. Improvements. There will be flaws. Nobody is beyond folly. There is no perfection. I am against perfection, please. Nothing is perfect. There can be lacunae. Please find out and add, subtract, and take the cognizance of the functional guide. Of course, everything that you are doing should be known to your faculty guide. Everything you are doing. What I like to take back with me, this is very important, please. I will go one after the other. My experience, experience itself counts. It is a real-time experience. First time I am open to real-time. 8-9 months I spent in DHRUVA is only theoretical, academic. How many case studies you might have done, still it is academic. It is confined to four walls. Now you see, it is real time. How to communicate in an organization? How to present myself in board meetings? How to talk to clients? How to make cold calls? How to do client mapping? How to do marketing and promotions? There are certain things which are related to rural marketing the XYZ person has taken up. It may not apply to all. How to do marketing and promotions? How to reach rural markets? How to find out potential customers? Where to find potential buyers? Touch points for marketing products. This can be changed a bit depending upon your project profile.